Hello, hello, hello. I recorded 1 minute ago the German version and I was very, very fast. I always get complaints from people, oh, I cannot concentrate so long. So they want me to make some fast food videos, which I'm not a fan of. There are so much videos of this on YouTube, these 3 minutes demos. They are never reviews, all demos. I don't like this so much. So my videos are longer. Yeah, I ramble a little bit. We got here the Slick SL60. We are here in the clean channel, British mode, that's Marshall mode. Let me switch to the Fender mode, to the USA mode here. That's my clean sound, neck pickup. So neck pickup is nice and warm, middle position. Oh, can you hear all this sustain, or will be a big topic today? And the bridge pickup. Yeah, this guitar is a tone machine, almost like its sister, the SL59, just with an additional neck pickup. And you heard it, the neck pickup is more a bluesy sounding warm P90, which is a nice addition to this very rock sounding bridge pickup. You could hear it, hopefully. Bridge pickup, more aggressive, neck pickup, warm, and in the middle position, best of both worlds in my opinion, okay? You still got the attack and the warmth of the neck pickup. Let me switch here quickly through all the sounds. It's a very healthy sounding guitar. Do you say that in English too? Rich and I really like it. Okay, we got here a Swamp Ash body, very light body. This guitar is 3.2 kilograms. We got a massive brass bridge, wrap around bridge. You can adjust all 6 saddles. You can fix them. We got here 2 screws on each side. So it's really a fixed massive bridge if it's adjusted from you. The tools come with the parcel, by the way. A very, very nice and interesting bridge. I never saw a bridge like this before, I have to say. And we got a volume pot, and this is a 500k pot, and this is indeed a brass knob, okay? This is really a brass knob. And we got the 3-way switch for the neck pickup, both pickups, and bridge pickup, and this knob here is brass 2. The strap pins are, in my opinion, brass 2, and the tuning pegs here are brass 2. They are crazy, okay? Brass everywhere, and it adds to the tone in my opinion. We got here 2 Slick Junior pickups, and they are really made for these guitars, okay? These are not generic pickups in any way. I was really surprised how good they sound. We got here 8 kilo ohms on the neck pickup, 9.6 kilo ohms on the bridge pickup, and yeah, I already talked about them, how they sound bluesy and rocking in the bridge position. Very, very nice pickups, and they are aged. All the screws are a little bit corroded, you know, rusty, and we got here a little bit a scar or something. And yeah, this guitar is also available, if I'm not wrong, in white with black pickups, in black with cream pickups, and in yellow with cream pickups. We got here, of course, TV yellow with black pickups. I really like this combination. I'm normally not a fan of yellow, but it looks nice, like this satin. And so here we got here really the bare wood, and the aging is done nice. Really nice looking guitar. So I talked about the pickups. Let's look into the electronic cavity quickly here.
Hello. Oh, and what is there to say? We got graphite lacquer everywhere. That's extremely good. I like this. And here the electronic cavity cover is shielded too. No problems there so far. They really take even care so that this, you know, these connectors here, they are isolated too. So that the metal from the pickup cable here cannot make any contact with this here. Very, very good. We got a big volume pot, by the way. I know it's a big deal for everybody, for many people. And yeah, the three-way switch, toggle switch, I was really surprised how massive, how solid this switch is. Really, really good switch. I cannot see any problem here. Okay, let's continue. Yeah, the input jack metal, okay, everything metal here too. And the back plate is massive steel, okay. This is not nickel-plated stuff, something really steel. And we got here Mr. Slick himself and the serial number. The block, by the way, yeah, we got here a big block. But if you reach it, if you feel it, your fingers are already on the last fret. So we got here no problem to reach the last fret, okay? And it helps, of course, a lot that we got here this high glossy fretboard. Yeah, we got here a maple neck, Canadian hard rock maple neck, one piece and a glued on headstock. Nice C shape, placed nice in my hand here. In my opinion, it feels like a neck that should fit everyone, not a very specific U-shaped neck or something. Very, yeah, fits for everyone in my opinion. Okay, we got a rosewood fretboard and it's a nice piece of wood, I have to say. And they made something special here. They polished it and made a thin coat of clear lacquer, clear coat. Made a thin clear coat on top of it and polished it too. So we got here really almost mirror shine fretboard. The frets also, medium jumbo frets, mirror shine. And that helps of course a lot with the playability of, especially with hammer-ons and pull-offs. Because the fretboard is so smooth, there's no resistance or anything. Feels like a super, super smooth modern guitar. Looks like a very, very old, rusty guitar. Doesn't feel like it. So nice and easy to play, okay? And yeah, next thing, we got a graphite nut. Very well slotted, no problems on this. 12-inch radius got the fretboard, by the way. Easy to play, comfortable. We got a 628mm scale length. Yes, of course, the standard short scale length for this kind of guitar. I always have to think on this rock move when I think of this scale length, you know, because... Yeah, of the short scale length, we always got this little wow out of tune sound sometimes when we hit the strings hard. And now to finish it off so we can play, the tuners, they don't make any problem. They are not brand tuners, no Grovers or something, but they don't make any, got any issues. And we got here, yeah, like I said, the brass knobs. I would call them high mass tuners. You can feel there's something going on between here and there. We got here brass and we got there brass. And the string really got a lot of power when you touch it. It's like the brass would help the string a lot to ring out clearly and long, okay? So, and we got an ash veneer here on top of the headstock and the Slick logo. This K is Mr. Slick himself, by the way, and this is white lacquer. So we got the specs, I think. I was very fast. We got here white dots, by the way, on the side dots, and the dots on the fretboard itself too. Everything is done nicely. No problems on this guitar. We are done with the specs. You could see everything is good. This is a good guitar. I had some complaints in my last video with the SL59, not about me, about the length of my video, okay, but more about that we don't got a tone pot on these guitars. You always have to remember that the tone pot can be a tone sucker, you know. You got a resistance here. The tone pot is a resistance.
in some way. And there is a difference. If you got a guitar with a tone pot, please solder the tone pot out and you will realize that the tone will be different, better normally, more high-end, clearer tech, something like this. I experienced this myself a lot. So there could be really a reason that they really said no to tone pots, okay? And yeah, this guitar is really a tone monster in my opinion. Let me start again with the AC tone a little bit. Just in case this is too bright for you sounding, I will switch from the Fender mode to the Marshall mode, okay? Yeah, crazy what the bridge pickup already did here, okay? Very aggressive sounding. Did I show you already the volume pot, how it works? No. Okay, the volume pot works very, very effective. We can really go from gain, and we turn it down, and we got clean sounds, and we lose no high end, okay? The volume pot very dynamically, okay? And yeah, let me play here with the neck pickup AC tone. Let me show you the dynamic quickly here again with the volume pot. Let me switch here between bridge pickup and neck pickup again, just the way I do it if the camera is off normally, okay? And you will see how I use these two pickups together, okay? Something like this, okay? You see, I switch to the leads almost always to the neck pickup. Really, really like the dynamics of both pickups together. And we will go into the ultimate drive. More gain, thicker, warmer. Let's see how this sound. Maybe I will make some switches. This sound. Really, really a rocking tone monster. Maybe we need some more brightness, I'm not sure. I will use here more treble. Okay, middle position quickly. And the neck pickup. Now the volume pot is very usable. I will show you this. You're now full. Pickup positions are usable in every situation, in my opinion. If it's a little bit too much with gain on the neck pickup, just turn the volume pot a little bit down and you could use this sound, for example, for an intro, and then switch to your fat bridge pickup again. Excellent. Okay, high gain tones, drop tuning, and I will show you the dynamic here too. We can really use the volume pot so nice, okay? I got here really two overdrives on, the Tube Screamer clone and the OCD clone. And now we can work with the volume pot, okay? Very nice dynamic range, long sustain, fat sounds, really nice clean sounds. P90 pickups are really, really good on this guitar. Okay, let me continue a little bit this down tuning playing here, drop tuning. Thank you. monster, okay? What is Sound Monster? Can really deliver everything, can give you the Gary Moore sound if you need it. Okay, final words. So this guitar costs around 299 euros. I will put the links with the German distributors in the description below, okay? Some of them ship worldwide. Otherwise, check for your own country. I'm not sure where you can get them in Australia, for example. But yeah, 299 euros. And you cannot complain, in my opinion, okay? That's such a great guitar. I love these pickups. Light body, high gloss fretboard, very well done frets. We got brass, everywhere on this guitar, even the strap pins, in my opinion. Very well constructed guitar. And such a tone monster, okay? This is the Slick SL60 TV Yellow Tone Monster, okay? That should be the name of the guitar. Very impressed with these guitars, okay? Both the SL59 and the SL60. Yeah, so please check them out. I will stop the rambling here right now. I think you heard it. If you got questions, please come in my Facebook groups. All the links are in the description below. Please check out Dozer Caps. Fantastic what Petro builds here. We got here, by the way, a Jensen C12K speaker in here, and I mic it up here with two mics. And yeah, check out the distributor list from Music Vine. I will put in the description too. I get always the questions, man, where can I get these guitars? So there's this list. And yeah, Slick Guitars, check them out. Really surprised. Yeah, have a nice day. Thanks for watching. I hope you liked it. Please let me know if my videos are really too long for you. So I will have to cut them down to 5 minutes or something. Hey, nice guitar. Hey, sounds good. Hey, bye. I don't know if this is the right way. So, bye-bye.